chairpersons of the parliamentary accountability committees that have taken on Prime Minister Right Honourable Robina Nabanja, who accused them of being corrupt. MPs claim the Prime Minister is trying to divert the probe into the controversial disbursement of COVID-19 relief funds and support to vulnerable persons. They've now tasked the new Prime Minister to substantiate her claims.
Prime Minister Robina Nabanja revealed yesterday that the government has started on an investigation to expose opposition members of parliament who use their positions as heads of accountability committees to amass illicit wealth. This statement has not gone down well with chairpersons of accountability committees who have asked Nabanja to either substantiate her claims or withdraw them.
She needs to know that in her position, the utterances and the statements that she makes needs to be based on facts and figures, because we have to be held accountable for what we say. And I think we need to avoid making blanket statements, but also emotional statements.
If the Prime Minister has any information to the effect that any of the leaders has accumulated wealth wrongly, she really knows what to do. Let her take that information to either the IGG or the DPP, because these MPs are not above the law. They will be arrested, they will be prosecuted. So it's not important wise for her to just make a statement in the media without really substantiating.
If she's talking about wealth accumulation, she has to first ask her bosses, because her bosses are too rich. In fact, if they are to investigate, it should start with her own bosses. We wonder how some people who are supposed to get a monthly salary of four millions, how they come to spend more than 400 millions almost monthly. So she's trying to create what we call diversion, of which may not be of importance at the moment.
Accountability committee heads have denounced the allegations with contempt and added that they have gone a long way to establish measures to weed out corrupt tendencies from committee members.
If anybody thinks that a leader is either under-declaring or failing to disclose, there is also a procedure under the leadership code to investigate the wealth. You can raise an objection to state that so and so has not made full disclosure, is under disclosing, or has not disclosed. So it's not really up to the Prime Minister to take it unto herself to begin discussing the issue of people's wealth.
In as far as wrecking, spying, interrogating people who are using those offices for personal gain, we are to base on that. I think he does not speak anything different from what Honorable Chagurani told us.
The vice chairperson of the Local Government Accounts Committee, Lutamaguzi Semakula, has called upon Parliament to sanction Nabanja if she can't adduce evidence to cement her accusations, which taints the image of Parliament.
If she could come out and maybe identify individuals that such and such a person came to be a chairperson of a certain committee, was very poor, or somehow poor, but now is very rich, by citing the kind of words she's talking about. I understand MPs are not angels, we all come from different backgrounds, but she couldn't generalize that opposition MPs who are heading accountability committees are corrupt. Like who? In fact, she deserves to be taken to disciplinary committee of parliament to explain.
Members of parliament claim Nabanja's utterances are meant to divert the public accounts committee and the local government accounts committee from probing the controversial disbursement of COVID-19 relief cash.
Maybe she's talking about all the committees of 10th parliament, but not 11th parliament, because we have not even served more than a month. And actually, we haven't yet interacted with several organizations as we're supposed to do. So if she makes such allegations, she's trying to divert you from the current matter which is being investigated. I mean, the COVID funds, which is a principle in terms of management. So she's trying to diversify, all to take away all powers that have been put on her, especially in terms of investigating the resources which she might have misappropriated.
If you say that 6,000 people may received 200,000, you know what it means? That means that like 1.2 billion money was wasted. So when such information comes out, I know, I understand, because the office of the Prime Minister was responsible for each and everything. She might be quaking at the moment because she knows things are not going to be good for her, for our office.
Opposition Chief Whip John Baptist Nambeshe hit back at Nabanja, saying she has no moral authority to fight graft in opposition when the office of the Prime Minister remains a theater of corruption scandals.
Right Honorable Nabanja, who is the Prime Minister and doubling as a leader of government business, is the head honcho of OPM, Office of the Prime Minister, which is riddled with grand corruption. What has she done? Why, what is she waiting for to crack the whip? You should not go for the small fish.
As allegations of corruption in parliamentary accountability committees continue to go around, 9 OPM officials were interdicted earlier this week over fake Kasese relief items. Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.